Contentious social media posts have come back to haunt two more political hopefuls in this year's general election. But both National and Labor are adamant their respective candidates no longer hold the controversial opinions. Here's senior political reporter Benedict Collins.
You've got a couple of generations of housing in
the We do.
If Labor gets its way, there will be a lot more of these on our roofs. The lure, a $4,000 grant.
$2,000 for the panels, $2,000 for the battery.
Which are good for households because it saves them money, and good for our climate because it reduces our climate emissions.
The Greens say their offer's better.
We could see one in three houses have solar within 15 years, as well as a bunch of public housing. Labor's policy will only cover 20% of the cost and is at a much smaller scale.
Chris Hipkins going on the climate attack today, arguing National's policies mean we won't meet our first emissions budget.
The National Party are indicating that they want the emissions trading scheme to do the heavy lifting when it comes to reducing our emissions. For that to happen, we're talking significant increases in petrol prices.
We are deeply committed to doubling the amount of renewable electricity in this country and doing so quickly, because we think that will make the transition from fossil fuels to clean energy much quicker.
But Christopher Luxon spent a lot of his time today talking about his candidate for Hamilton East, Ryan Hamilton.
He was wrong. He subsequently apologised for those remarks, and those comments are utterly unacceptable, and they are wrong. That's completely inappropriate. It's inappropriate, and he's wrong.
It seems Ryan Hamilton's no fan of fluoride, posting his views on social media. National knew this when they selected him, but say he's changed his mind.
His views is the National Party, and he's come out very clearly and said that very strongly, that actually fluoridation in water is important.
Generally speaking, I haven't found conspiracy theorists are that willing to change their views.
So you're calling him a conspiracy theorist?
Well, people who buy into the anti-vax, anti-fluoride movement generally tend to be.
Speaking of anti-vax, Labour List candidate Deborah Rhodes believes the HPV vaccine is big pharma poison that makes boys and girls sterile.
Happy to look at that. I don't believe that to be true.
Labour issued a statement on behalf of Deborah Rhodes this afternoon saying she no longer believes the HPV vaccine is poison. Now apparently she thinks it's safe and effective.
Two more political hopefuls whose bosses say have had a complete change of mind. Benedict Collins, One News.
And with the campaign well underway, who'll be Prime Minister after the election? To help you decide, make sure you tune into the first leaders' debate tomorrow night between Chris Hipkins and Christopher Luxon, hosted by One News political editor Jessica Mutch-McKay. That's straight after the news hour at 7 o'clock.